Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Awesome, awesome, awesome moment here in this presence. There is nothing you cannot do, protocol breaker. There is nothing you cannot do, Jehovah overdo. I have tasted of your love. I see your mighty works. Mighty mover, Jehovah, on your money, mama. Hallelujah. You are welcome. We are welcome. God bless you. You are welcome to another wonderful episode of Boldness in Christ Jesus. Today is another awesome moment in His presence. God bless you. Welcome, 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 welcome. As you join me this evening, kindly share the video. Today's topic is very, very important for everyone. And not just only that, today's topic is very, very sensitive. You can see the topic of today. You are a target. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. You are a target. That's the topic of today. And we are going to look into today's topic. What makes you a target? Why are you really a target? And what must you do? What must you do for you not to fall into the hands of the predators? Those that are seeking or that are after you. I celebrate you, the son of my father. God bless you. I can see you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for joining. Please, as you join me this evening, kindly share the video and the Lord will bless you richly. Because today's topic is very, 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 very sensitive. I'm going to be sharing an experience with you, and I believe it's going to boost you up. Glory to God in the highest. The topic says you are a target. Hallelujah. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, above before your throne. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, bow before your throne, bow before your throne, worship at your feet. I bow before your throne. You are the glorious God. Man of God, I celebrate you. Thank you for joining me all the way from Kenya. God bless you, sir. Thank you for joining. Today is another wonderful episode of Boldness in Christ Jesus. Another awesome moment in His presence. Glory to Jesus Christ. Today's topic says, you are a target. Kale bradosh ala balagadosh kendeli bragadosh. Eria ragazondo buskandele kanamashata. Erro dog buskandele kanamashata. I celebrate you, Apostle, all the way from Italy. Apostle Pigio, thank you, sir, for joining. Glory to God. Please, as you come alive with me, kindly share the video so that more people will join us this evening, because today's topic is very, very sensitive. You are a target. That is the topic. And we are going to look into this topic today, Calebradosha. And I know that this topic is going to touch you. This topic is going to boost a lot of energy and potential out of you. This topic is going to bring a turnaround in your life. This topic is going to touch you and you're going to bounce back. Hallelujah. I just want you to, please, as you come live with me, kindly share the video so that more people will join us this evening so that they will be blessed. Because as you share the video, you are equally preaching the gospel. Glory to God and the highest. The Bible said, go into the world and preach the gospel. Holy hallelujah. As you share the video, you are equally preaching the gospel. And as you share the video, you will share your testimony. Testimony upon testimony will be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, may you reign, may you reign. Jesus, may you reign, may you reign. Yesterday, you reign. You reign in my life. Oh Lord, come and reign forever. reign and reign forevermore. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we bless your holy name. We worship you. We magnify your name, for you alone is worthy to be praised. Lord, as we are about to hear your word, Abba Father, touch my tongue with your coal of fire. Let your word that will come out of my mouth this evening, let it bring divine healing, divine breakthrough, divine restoration, divine settlement. Father, I have no power of my own. I yield myself to you, Lord, as a living sacrifice. Use me, Lord, as your vessel of honor unto your own glory, and your name alone will be glorified, your name alone will be exalted. For in Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. You are welcome to another wonderful episode of Boldness in Christ Jesus. Today is another awesome moment in his presence. Another wonderful topic. Glory to God. Another powerful topic that is going to touch you today. Another powerful topic that you are going to sit down and meditate on. Today, I think today is 8th of January. You know, when we enter the year, January is always very, very, it takes a lot of time before it will just allow everybody to rest. After January, the year, we start moving very fast. Hallelujah. So today's topic says, you are a target. Glory to God. Let us open our Bible this evening. I'm just going to pick the last part of that verse in the Bible. Glory to God. The last verse of that Bible is where I'm going to pick. Let us open our Bible this evening to Proverbs chapter 2, verse 12. Hallelujah. Please open your Bible with me. It's very important. The word of God is power. The word of God is truth. The word of God is light. The Bible said the word of God is a light and a lamp unto our path and unto our feet. So you can see the word of God is very important. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Let us open our Bible this evening to Proverbs chapter 2, verse 12. It's a very popular place in the Bible. But I would still like us to open our Bible. God bless you, the son of my father, Collins, brother Collins, God bless you. Apostle Paul, I celebrate you, man of God, all the way from Zambia. Thank you very much for joining. Thank you, God bless you. Please, as you join today's episode of Boldness in Christ Jesus, kindly share the video. A lot of people need to listen to this topic. A lot of people need to hear this message. Hallelujah. It's a message that is going to help a lot of people to bounce back. Because a lot of people don't really know that they are the target. Hallelujah. They don't know that they are a target. A target of the kingdom of darkness. Glory to God. Let us open our Bible to Proverbs 2, verse 12. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Glory, 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 glory to God. And it says, I'm going to pick the last part of this verse, but I'm going to read it from the beginning of the verse. And it says, to deliver thee from the way of the evil man, from the man that speaketh forward. Hallelujah. No, hallelujah to Jesus. It's not Proverbs, Philippians. I'm sorry. I wanted to say Philippians, I said Proverbs. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Glorious God. Beautiful King. Excellent God. You are welcome, Abba, before your throne. The Bible said, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only. Hallelujah. Mark that word. Not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence. Walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. This last part is where I'm going to dwell on. Walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Glory to God in the highest. My labor zondo, you are welcome. I celebrate you, the daughter of my father, Evangelist Atrata. God bless you. Thank you for joining. Please, as you come alive with me this evening, kindly share the video because a lot of people need to listen to today's topic. It's a very, very sensitive topic. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. From where we read, it said, walk out your own salvation. Your own salvation. Your own. Mark that word. Your own salvation. with fear and trembling. Glory to God in the highest. Your own salvation. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Today's topic says you are a target. You are a target. A lot of people don't really know that they are the target of the kingdom of darkness. A lot of people don't really know that what they carry is a threat, a great threat to the kingdom of darkness. And that is why the powers of the kingdom of darkness have made them a target. And where I want to come from in today's topic is that a lot of people don't really know that whatever that is happening right now is because they are a target to the kingdom of darkness. Powers are making a lot of people right now to wax cold when it comes to the things of God. A lot of people today, they are waxing cold when it comes to the things of God. A lot of people today, they no longer focus on the things of God. A lot of people are beginning to lose it. They are beginning to mix it. They are beginning to mix it in one way or the other. Some now even fighting, they think they are fighting for God, forgetting that the salvation is their own. The Bible says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. It did not say work out the salvation of another, but your own salvation. That is where I'm going to come out this evening. That is where I want to speak on this evening. Because there is so much tribulation right now. There is so much confusion right now. There is so much issue right now. There is so much trials, trouble everywhere right now. A lot of people don't really understand this whole thing is happening because they are what? They are being targeted. So this topic says you are a target. That you are a target is a normal thing, but you must not make yourself a prey. That they are targeting you is normal, but you must not make yourself a prey. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. That is why I said we should open the Bible this evening to the place where the word of where we are being warned, where we are being told that we should walk out our own salvation with fear and trembling. What does that mean? You should focus, be focused, be focused. A lot of people have been distracted. A lot of people are distracted in one way or the other because of what they see on internet, because of one thing or the other somebody is saying. And they are being distracted. Listen to me, my brothers and my sister. That is why you should acknowledge the fact that you are a target. It's just like Peter, apostle that was with Jesus Christ. He never knew that he was a target. Why was he a target? Because of what he carries. The Bible makes us to understand that Jesus told him, he said, Satan came last night and wanted to see if he said, but I have prayed for you. Which means Peter did not know that he was a target. Likewise, a lot of people don't really understand that they are being targeted. There is so much target on them based on what they carry, based on who God has destined them to be. The kingdom of darkness is after them in one way or the other, just to make sure that they don't exhibit or bring out that potential that God has really deposited inside them. That is why in this end time, you must make sure that you are focused. You must make sure that you are spiritual. Like what I always say in the church, make sure that you're always spiritually at alert. Because the kingdom of darkness is they are out now with so much, they are in a hurry. They are looking for what? They are looking for how to make people to fall. If you look at what is happening on the internet today, a lot of people are falling in one way or the other. They don't even know that they are just making mistakes. They think they are fighting for God. They think that they are, and you know that the more, there is something I want to say. Do you know that what you listen to, what you watch, can have effect in your mindset? If you focus on negative things, before you know it, it will start making you to start having negative mindset. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. If you focus on negative posts, especially on social media, if you focus, especially maybe when you are inside the church, you focus on negative things, You will always end up having a negative mindset. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. That is why the Bible makes us to understand in Proverbs 4 verse 23. It said we should guide our hearts diligently. Guide your heart diligently. What does that mean? If you don't guide it diligently, any toxic can enter. Let me give you an example. Maybe if you are listening to a music now, do you know that even when you off that music, you will still be having the music, it will look as if the music is still rewinding in your mind. Jesus. So sorry for that intrude. Hallelujah. I don't know what happened to whatever it is that I'm using. Glory to God. If you look at it, you will find out that there is a kind of issue coming up from there. Hallelujah. Just 1 minute. Let me fix it. Glory to God in the highest. Today's message is very, very sensitive. I'm not surprised. I've been having some strange feeling about it. And I know that whether the devil likes it or not, I'm going to do it. I'm going to share the message. And the message is going to go around. Everybody's going to hear it. Just 1 minute. Let me fix this thing. Glory to God. If you like what I was, the example that I was trying to give. Glory to God. If you look at, just like what I said, if you are listening to music, you will find that after listening to the music, you will still be having, let me just forget it so that I will concentrate. Glory to God. If after listening to the music, you are no longer where the music, you have off the music, but you will just find that the music will still keep on playing in your mind. Hallelujah to Jesus. The music will still keep on playing in your mind. What does that mean? That was what you took in at that very moment. That was something that you accepted inside you at that very moment. You will find out that it will start rewinding. It will start rewinding over and over again. That is how it is when you allow negative things to fill your mindset. Hallelujah. Let me go on with the things I wrote down. I wrote something down. I said, if you look at the life of David, David was a target right from childhood. He was a target. Why? Because of who God has destined him to be. Because of who God has, because of what he carries. Because of the personality that God has created him to be. He became a target. The Bible makes us to understand that even from his mother's womb, he was rejected. From his mother's womb, he was rejected. David experienced rejection right from the mother's womb. Hallelujah. I'm sorry I'm moving because I want to fix this thing somehow so that I'll be able to drop the camera and be able to concentrate more. Glory to God in the highest. Just 1 minute. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. The devil is a liar. Today's topic is very, very sensitive. And I know, I'm not surprised. I've been having a kind of, what will I call it? Hallelujah. It's better like this so that my hand will be free. Glory to God. Glory, glory, glory. If you look at the life of David, David was a target. Even right from the mother's womb. Why? Because he was the one that was going to kill Goliath. Why? Because he has the potentials to deliver the children of Israel from the hand of Goliath. That was why he was a target. A lot of people today, their kingdom of darkness is targeting them, trying to make sure that they are being distracted, trying to make sure that they fall apart. Do you know that a lot of people have started backsliding? And let me tell you something. If you are in that lane right now, please don't fall. Please, I beg you in the name of God, don't backslide. Do you know that when someone backslides, it's not easy to come back? Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. And when someone backslides, it's very, very difficult to come back. I can tell you that because I have experienced it. I can bet on it because I have experienced it. I was there once. I can tell you that when somebody out of maybe anger or maybe offense, the Bible says offense will always come. When somebody, because of anger, because of offense, and end up backsliding, my dear, that means you have allowed yourself to become a prey. Yes, because the kingdom of darkness knows that you are going to scatter one or two things. You are going to deal with his kingdom. They will come in different ways to get you offended. They will come in different ways to make you feel bad. They will come in different ways to make you fall. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. That is one of the major points I want to hit on today. Because a lot of Christians today, they have started wasking cold. A lot of Christians today, even some pastors, they have started wasking cold. A lot of Christians today, because of what they see on social media that has to do with pastor or has to do with church, they have started wasking cold. They are even the one that is even sharing it the more. Listen, they are using it as a target to target you. You are the target. That man of God is not the target. That church is not the target. The Bible said, the kingdom of God will always move on. The gate of hell will never prevail against it. So no matter what they are posting, no matter what they are saying, listen to me, my brothers and sisters. Your Christianity, your salvation is the target. It's not that man of God. It's not that woman of God. Your salvation is the target. That is why I said we should open our Bible to Philippians 2 verse 12, which says that you should walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. You are the target. That they are targeting you doesn't mean that they have the right to succeed. Like what I always say, they have the right to try, but they don't have the right to succeed. The right to succeed is in your hand. You are the one that will give them the right to succeed. That is why I always say they have the right to try, they don't have the right to succeed. That they are making you a target, you must not make yourself a prey. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. That they are making you a target, but you as a person must make sure that you are not a prey. Because when you allow them to turn you to a prey, that is where they will succeed in targeting, in that target that they have been targeting you. And that will never be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, if you look at the story of Joseph was also a target. But he did not allow himself to become a prey. He was also a target. But he did not allow, because they are targeting him he did not allow that aspect of his life to make him not to become who God had destined him to be. Look at what he went through. He was thrown inside the pit. They sold him. He became a slave. He became a prisoner. From there, that was her. But he did not allow that aspect, because the brothers targeted him. Why? Because they knew. Because he told them his dream. Do you know why you must be very careful the people you talk to? The people you confide in. There are some people, when you not confide in them, you tell them what God has revealed to you about yourself. You just find out that these same people will start using it, trying to fight, trying to make sure it doesn't come to manifestation. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. So whatever, some people they have made themselves a prey, because maybe they have been praying and praying and praying. That thing they have been asking God for have not come to manifestation, and they get discouraged. They was cold. Do you know that the very day you ask God for that thing, that was the very day God answered? Yes, it can be delayed. Powers can delay it not to come to manifestation. Just like what happened to Daniel. The Bible said Daniel prayed. He was not supposed to pray for 21 days. But he ended up in praying for 21 days. Why? Because power, the prince of Persia, held what the angel of the Lord was bringing to him. And the Bible said the very day he set himself to pray, that was the very day his prayer was answered. A lot of people right now, they are wasting cold because they have been praying. Listen to me, my brothers and sisters. The major message for you today is that you must not serve God because of what you want or what you need. In this 2022, you have to serve God because you love God. You have to serve God because of the passion you have for God. You have to serve God because of the mindset, the love you have for God. The Bible says the one of the greatest commandment is that we should love the Lord our God with all our heart, with all our mind. The Bible even makes us to understand that he first loved us. What manner of love is that for a man to lay down his life for you and I? And the Bible says, even while we were yet sinners, he did not say because we are still committing sin that he would not die on the cross of Calvary for our sake. No, he still went and had to share his blood for you and I. So what is that thing that you want to allow to make you to fall What is that thing that you want to allow to make you to make mistake that will not make you to backslide from the things of God? A lot of people no longer go to church. A lot of people don't even read their Bible anymore. A lot of people don't pray anymore. Why? And you think you are doing that person? No, you are doing yourself because you are the target. Let me share a story with you. When I was growing up, in my JSS1, I was the first JSS1 student to preach in our General Assembly. For you to know where I have been coming from. Hallelujah. I was burning for Christ at that very tender age. I go to church 24/7. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. I do preach, because our BK mistress, Mrs. Ojomo, I'm still searching for that woman. Because I want her to know. I just want to tell her, Mama, I am back on my feet again. Because that woman, she was our BK mistress. When I fell, when I backslide, that woman cried. She did everything to make me come back to Christ. I did not listen to her. I fell, I backslide, just because of what happened inside the church. I ended up not going to church. Even the church ended up, because what happened really affected the church. Even the church closed. Because I don't want to mention the name of the, but I don't know whether it's still existing. That thing happened, and I cried. The matter was none of my business. Anyway, it was none of my business. It was something that happened between the who and who inside the church. So that thing affected a lot of people. A lot of people stopped coming to church. And because of that thing, I lost my let me say, I fell. I backslid. Do you know, for me to come back to Christ, I'm led to share this testimony with you. So that if you are on the lane to fall, I want you to listen to this testimony. It's my personal story. It's not so, you know, I always share my personal story. Because I want you to know that you are a target. When I backslide, I was the target. Not whoever whatever that happened to whoever it happened to inside the church, that we are the target. I was the target. Years moved on. 5 years, 10 years, I could not come back to, I was finding it difficult to come back to my feet again. Even when things are going wrong, I will run back to God, because already I was already speaking in tongues then, I was already in the choir department, I was in even the prayer warrior department, because when I started going to church, I was always, anything that has to do with church, I am there. I'm telling you, when I was very small. 5 years down the drain, 10 years down the drain. Whenever I have issue, I will run back to God. God, help me, please. I will come back to you. I will serve you. Do you know, immediately I pray that prayer, that thing will be settled. After a few days again, I will forget. I'll go back to the word. That was how I was falling and rising, falling and rising. I could not come back to God, to serve God with that kind of passion that I used to have for God. Sometimes I will cry, Lord, help me. I want to serve you. I want to come back to you. But I was not able to come back. Why? Because I was already having so many kind of relations, so many kind of friends, some kind of way, style of living. That's why when I see people, they are saying they are slave queen, they are slave queen. My dear, you are a target because of what you carry. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. I was finding it difficult to come back on my feet again. 5 years down the drain, 10 years down the drain, 15 years down the drain. Can you imagine if I did not backslide when I was very small, when I was serving God? You think I would be in the same level that I am right now in ministry or in my Christianity? No, I would have gone far. That is why today's message says you are the target. Don't think that whatever it is that is happening is because of some. No, you are the target. Many years was wasted. That is why sometimes I'll just be crazy, say, Lord, restore my wasted years in ministry. Many years went down the drain. I was not able to come back on my feet again. Why? Because I backslid and I entered the world. I started living a life that I weren't supposed to live. And from the beginning, I thought I was, level. But no, it was years that was just wasting. That is why the Bible said, it said, I will restore to you the years the canker worm and the palmer worm has eaten. It was years that was wasted. Even I saw rapture four good times. And that four good times, I did not make it. I will wake up sweating, crying. Oh, God, forgive me. Oh, Lord, forgive me. I will repent. 2, 3 days, 4 days, I will start praying. I will start doing everything. Before you know it, I will fall again. Four good times I saw rapture, I did not. I will just see. I know I will see the rapture. It will just happen, bam, and I did not make it. I knew it was God that was warning me. God was telling me to come back. But I wanted to, but I was not able to come back. That is why I'm telling each and everyone today, don't let whatever you see on internet, don't let whatever it is, anybody, any offense or whatever, the Bible says offense will come. Don't let it make you backslide. Don't let it make you fall. Because you are the target. What God has deposited in you is the target. Who God has created you to be is the target. The potential that God has placed in you is the target. I weren't able to come back to Christ. That passion that I had for God then, I weren't able to get it back until after how many years? It was in 2013. 2013, I started seeing posters everywhere. Even as I'm telling you now, I still go to church. But you know the kind of church mindset we do that time is just to go to church and all this fashion level, just to go to church and all this fashion level, all this what's up, babe, all this what they call now, they call it what is it called? A slay queen. People don't slay before now begin slay. There is nothing in it. There is no life in it. We go to church, but we don't go to church because we want to hear the word of God. We weren't going to church because we love God. We weren't going to church because we want to change. And that is exactly what is going on today. In many churches, they just go to church not because they love God. They just go to church not because they want to change. They just go to church not because they want to hear the word of God, but because of one reason or the other. Listen, in this 2022, you must make sure that your reason of serving God is because you love God, not because you need one miracle, not because you need one financial breakthrough, not because you need this or that, but because you love God. I am telling you my life story. I do go to church. Even then, there was one pastor. He saw me. He said, God is ministering to me that I have the capacity to preach the word of God. I didn't preach because between me, I said, with this kind of life I'm living, no, I can't. I don't want. I declined. I did not accept because of the kind of life I was living then. Until 2013. I'm telling you my story. I just saw flyers everywhere. They said one man of God is coming. Who? I didn't even know him. I don't know anything about him. The first day, I didn't go. Hallelujah. But the second day, something just said, why not just go and look? Because I started hearing, hey, now so they mention them. Now some people they follow. Now so this one they happen. I was like, why did they push them? Why are they falling? Let me go and see. And when I got there, I saw the manifestation of the power of God. I was looking at everybody. Some will be falling. Some are starting. I'm like, what did they fall? These people say, why are they falling? What is wrong with them? Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. But in that crusade, 2013, in my former city in Valencia, 2013, it was as if I just remember, I said, God, I want to come back. It was within me. I just prayed this prayer point. I said, God, that passion that I used to have for you when I was growing up, I need it. This is just what I need. If this man is your servant, Lord, use him to touch me. Listen, I came out from somewhere. I have a lot of story to share. Any day I'm allowed to share more, I will share more stories. But this one, I'm sharing this one now because it tallies with the topic of today. You are the target. That is why you must make sure that you don't allow anything to make you fall. Because a lot of people are backsliding. A lot of people are falling. I just prayed that simple prayer. And the next thing I heard, the man of God said, he said, there are 8 people here. In the next 8 months, the way their life is going to turn around is going to be drastic and people are going to be surprised. And the next thing I heard, 1, 2, that was all I heard. Later on, I found out I was on the floor. It now dawned on me. I now felt something inside me. I cried. Then my daughter wore it up to 1 year then, because I carried her in my hand. Immediately because I don't know how they were able to carry the baby for me, my daughter for me, so that she wouldn't fall or get harm. I don't know. When I was able, they now helped me to stand up. That was when I was able to bounce back. That is how I was able to come back on my feet again. That man of God that I'm talking about is Apostle Johnson Suleiman. That was in 2013. That is why when people are fighting him, people are saying all manner of things about him. Sometimes I engage with them because I know that God has also used him to touch my life. If he was fake, how come that thing that he did in 2013 was that prayer that I prayed was how I was able to bounce back. And when he left, Evangelist Isogbe took over. That was how I started growing. But one thing I want you to acknowledge in this my story. Before I was able to bounce back, more than 15 years have gone down the drain in my calling. More than 15 years have gone down the drain. I'm repeating it. Because do you know that when you backslide, to come back to Christ is not easy. That is why you must make sure that you walk out your own salvation in fear and trembling. That is why you must fight so that you will not fall. That is why you must fight and make sure that there are things that you are saying on internet that people are saying doesn't stick into your mindset. A lot of people today, they no longer go to church because of one story or the other. A lot of people today, they don't even have respect or reverence men of God or women of God because of what they have heard, because of the story, the fallacy, the fake news that is everywhere. Listen, you are the target. Your salvation is the target. You are the one that is being targeted. Those people that they are talking about, they don't walk afar. You are the one. Imagine if I did it. Backslide, then do you think I will be in the same level that I am today in ministry, in preaching the word of God? For that 15 years, do you know how many souls that went down the drain? Maybe if I didn't backslide, I would have been able to preach to some and they would have given their life to Christ. Do you know how many souls for 15 good years? What about if I had lost my life during that time that I backslide? What would have happened? Listen to me, my brothers and my sisters. I beg in the name of God. Walk out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Don't allow anything that is happening around you make you fall. Don't allow anything that you are hearing make you backslide. Don't allow anything, offense. The Bible said offense will always come. Don't allow the offense that because of one person have offended you or one person have done something wrong to you. And because of that, you not allow the love for God in your life, in your mind to die, to wax cold. Don't allow it because you are the target. That is the topic of today. You are the target. Those people are not the target. All the years that was wasted because I backslide. I know sometimes I do feel pains about it. Sometimes it breaks my heart. Because sometimes I'll be wondering, what about the people that I was supposed to preach the gospel to? For how many years that I was wallowing in the world? There is nothing in the world. In the world, what you always get according to the Bible is nothing but trouble. You can always get joy, peace through Christ. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Please, I beg you. That is why I am out today. That story is my story. It's not the story that someone told me. I am telling you my personal story. When I backslid, I couldn't come back. It was difficult. I fought. Sometimes I will go on fasting. I will still fall back. I became a Christian of rising and falling. I weren't even able to preach the gospel because of the kind of life I was living. I was ashamed. Because I'm not just only ashamed, I didn't even want to change. 2 days I will change. The third day I'm back. Listen, you are the target. Don't allow any power to make you backslide. Abstain. The Bible says abstain from evil. Abstain from evil. You that is judging one man of God, judging one woman of God. The Bible said, it said you that think that you are standing. He said, you should be careful, lest you too will fall. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. He said, you too should be careful, lest you fall. You are the target. Guide your heart diligently. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. In this 2022, make sure that your 2022 is for the love of God. Don't just go to church because everybody do go to church. But go to church because you love God. Read your Bible. Be more of God. That is, let your mind be filled with the love for Christ, the love for God. Don't just serve God because of what you need. Because you want miracle, you want money, you want to buy a car, you want to buy a house, or you want to. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things that you need, they will be added. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Please, I beg you in the name of God. That is what I'm led to share with you this evening. This is 2022. Let your Christianity be different. Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't backslide. If you're already backsliding little by little, you know, when somebody is about to backslide, it starts little by little. I'm talking with experience. I've been there. Walk back to God. Come back now before it's too late. Okay, you just imagine for those more than 15 years that I lost it, what about if I have lost my life? What would have happened? Okay, thank God I'm still alive. What about the souls that I was supposed to win in that 15 good years, more than 15 years? What happened? What about the people that I would have touched their life positively? Have you sit down to think about that? Please, I beg you in the name of God. Let whatever that you would take in be positive. Let whatever that you listen to be positive. Let whatever that you think on be positive. Let anything that you must hold in high esteem right now in 2002 must be your love for Christ. Your love for God, for the things of God, your passion for his word. That thing that you are seeking for, that thing that you are looking for, it will definitely come. I beg in the name of God. Sometimes when I see some people's comments on social media, I cry because they don't know that they are the target. Sometimes when I see some posts of pastors or churches that people are sharing on their Facebook, some will even be judging. The Bible says, who are you to judge another man's servant? It makes me cry because when I look at these people, you will find out that in their profile, they wrote that when you look at their profile where they wrote religion, they wrote Christian. They wrote Christian. But what you are posting is not reflecting to that you are a Christian. What you are posting is tear watching you. And you think that God doesn't know. He knows. Listen, my brothers and my sister, abstain from evil. Abstain from evil. Abstain from comments and posts that will not enhance the kingdom of God. Because why? You are the target. Your salvation is the target. Not whoever that is. Listen, do you know that even in social media, there are spirits? You think everybody on social media are human beings? Do you know that some posts can even be originated from the kingdom of darkness? Just to tarnish the image of the body of Christ. Just to tarnish the image of a man of God or a woman of God. Just to tarnish the image of a church. Do you know that? It can be orchestrated from the kingdom of darkness. Maybe because that man of God is really dealing with their kingdom. Maybe that ministry, that is where their kingdom is being scattered. They can orchestrate anything and place it on social media and everybody will start commenting. And you don't know that it will start affecting your prayer life, your Christianity. Hallelujah to Jesus. This is all I just have to share with you today. That they are targeting you doesn't mean that you must make yourself a prey. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Don't make yourself a prey. They have the right to try. They have the right to fight. They have the right to try to do whatever they want to do. But they don't have the right to succeed until you give them the right to succeed. Because your life is in your hand. I always say this. Your life is in your hand. That why am I saying this? The Bible says God can never force you. You have the will mind. God always, he said, I've placed before you life and death. You have the right to choose. You can see that your life is in your hand. He said, come unto me, all you that are labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You can see your life is in your hand. He said, draw near to me and I will draw near to you. You can see your life is in your hand. You have to take the decision. He said, the Bible also makes us, he said, whatsoever ye shall bound on earth shall be bound in heaven. You can see that your life is in your hand. That witches and wizards are flogging you, they are beating you. It's your fault because you did not flog them back. Because you gave them the right. Powers are fighting you. Yes, they have the right to fight, but they don't have the right to succeed. Because he said, I have given you the power to trample upon scorpions and serpents, and it shall not by any means hurt you. And that, what does that mean? He has given you the power. You have to walk it out. I preached a message some time ago. Who is your enemy? Who is your enemy? Many people, they are the enemy of themselves, and they are blaming witches and wizards. Witches and wizards, they don't have right over your life. It's when you allow them that they can come. It's when you allow them, that is when they can try, do whatever they want to do with you. But when you are spiritually sound, spiritually at alert, you can deal with them even more than you can think. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Before I go offline this evening, if you know you have not given your life to Christ, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Because that's the foundation you have to stand on. Hallelujah. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. I am a sinner. I repent of my sin. With my heart, I believe that you died on the cross of Calvary for my sake. And with my mouth, I confess you as my Lord and personal Savior. I will never go back to Satan again. You are welcome to the body of Christ. God bless you. Like what I always say, you have just started. You need a Bible-believing church so that you can grow. We have the mid-stage, the mid-stage, and the bone stage. You have to grow. Go to a Bible-believing church. You are listening. All these things that people are saying, you don't need to go to church. You don't need to go to church. The Bible said, do not forsake the gathering of the brethren. You have to go to church so that you can grow. What about the gift of God that is inside you? If you don't go to church for it to be built, or maybe you are destined to be a gospel artist, you no longer go to church. The only thing you do is just follow up on Facebook Live. Yes, I do Facebook Live, but I always tell people, go to church. You can follow somebody on Facebook Live and still go to church. Hallelujah. What about the potentials that God has placed inside you for you to exhibit in his house? Jesus Christ, our Lord and personal Savior, was always in the synagogue. Go and read your Bible. He was always in the synagogue. The apostles, they were always in the synagogue. When church came, they were always in the church. There was no time that they did not go to the gathering of the brethren. Look for a Bible believing church so that you can grow, so that that potential inside you that God has placed. Some of you are destined to be a Sunday school teacher. Some of you are destined to be an usher. Some of you are destined to be a sanctuary cleaner. Some of you are destined to be to be in the choir. So if you don't go to church, how will you now build that gift? How will you build it? Many people don't even go to Bible study. The only thing they know is only Sunday church, Sunday. Do you know that it's Bible study that you can ask questions? Maybe you read the Bible in your house and there was something that you didn't understand. It's in Bible study that you can ask questions. The Bible said the Ethiopian man was reading and reading and reading. He didn't understand what he was reading until Philip came and interpreted for him. There is possible you can read the Bible and will not understand. That is why you need to be in the Bible study where you can ask questions so that you can grow. Listen. This 2022, let it be a year that you will exhibit your love for Christ. Let it be a year that you will exhibit your love for God. Let it be a year that you will win souls for Christ. Let evangelism become part of you. Let winning soul for Christ become a passion. Listen, do it this year, 2022. You will see the difference. And for those that their love for Christ have waxed cold, maybe because you have asked God for something, you have been praying and it didn't come to manifestation, and your love for Christ have waxed. Listen to me. That is why I said serve God because you love God. Don't serve God because of what God can do for you. Don't serve God because there is something that you are asking. I've lived that life. I told you when I backslide, when something hit me on the head, boom, I will run back to God. Don't live that kind of life. It's only when the things are sweet you say thank God. No. Listen, if your love for Christ have waxed cold, your passion for the word of God have waxed cold, please, I beg in the name of God, let your heart be filled with love for Christ. No matter what it is that you are going through right now, He knows. The Bible said in Corinthians, it said, nothing that you are going through right now that no one has never been there. Yes, that thing that you are going through, someone has been there. And the person came, and there's something I always say on Facebook Live. You check your life from when you were born, as you were growing up. Does it mean that you have not been in one issue or the other, and you came out? So what is it now that is making you to wax cold when it comes to the things of God? I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For the Spirit of the living God to rest upon you and energize you to bounce back in the name of Jesus. I pray for the passion for the word of God to envelop you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it is that have been become a reproach in your life that is making you to wax cold when it comes to the things of God, I pray that God should put an answer to that question mark. That but in your life, I pray for you to receive divine intervention in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Thank you all for joining me. I'm led to pray for, if you know that you are sick, if you know that you have pain in your body, wherever that pain is, that I am led to pray for you. If you know that you are sick, place your hand in that place. Place your hand in that place. That pain in your leg, place your hand there. That heart pain, that heart problem, that kidney problem, that liver problem, pancreas problem, lung problem, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Malika tosha reka tosken de libra gadon shada la balagazon eria ragazon dog buskan de lekana mashata erra da brasken de libra gazo. I command that sickness to come out of your body, that pain in your head, migraine out, problem in your eyes out, that issue in your heart out, that kidney problem, that liver problem, whatever it is, a pain in your neck, in your leg, in your shoulder, in your bone, in your backbone, in your waist, wherever that sickness is located, wherever that pain is located, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be healed in the name of Jesus. Let the healing power of God fall upon you now. Let the healing power of God rest upon you now. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are healed and you are healed completely. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Thank you all for joining. Boldness in Christ Jesus is every Saturday, 7 p.m. Spanish time, 7 p.m. Nigeria time right now, because we are in the winter. 8 p.m. South Africa time, 6 p.m. UK time, 1 p.m. New York time. Hallelujah. There is a good news. Glory to God. Next week, Saturday, in Boldness in Christ Jesus, we are going to be having relationship tips. Hallelujah. We are going to have some guests going to be with us. Men of God and woman of God is going to be with us. They are going to talk on what we call relationship tips. Hallelujah. Relationship tips for single brothers and single sisters. If you are married, also join. Yes, you are welcome, because it's obvious there are some certain things you can also learn. So next week, Saturday, is going to be relationship tips. Before you marry, there are so many things that you need to know. Hallelujah. So that you don't make mistakes. There are so many mistakes in marriages today. Hallelujah. So that day, we have a man of God that is going to join us. We have a woman of God that is going to join us. And there is also a brother. Even when I asked, are you a man of God? He said, no, the way he started, no. It was so funny. He's not a man of God, but when he has, he's into this relationship matter. So he's highly inclined when it comes to relationship matter. So next week, Saturday, we are going to be having guests to talk on relationship tips for singles. Don't be left out. Don't miss it. You are going to be blessed. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Till I come your way again next week, Saturday, always be bold in Christ Jesus. When you are bold in Christ Jesus, you can never backslide. The Bible said the righteous are as bold as a lion. When you are bold in Christ Jesus, they can target you, but they can never turn you to their prey. When you are bold in Christ Jesus, you will always succeed. You will always be able to fight and stand. Hallelujah. Till I come your way again next week, Saturday, God bless you. Jesus loves you, and so do I. I love you all. Shalom. And please, if you have not shared this video, kindly share this video. Because when you share this video, you are equally winning souls for Christ. Just like the testimony of my life that I gave. If you share this video with somebody, you will find out that that person's life will also be touched. That is why it's very important we share testimony. Because when you share testimony, you are equally building the faith of others. When you share testimony, you are making people to understand that if that same God can do it for you, you can also do it for them. When you share testimony, you are all equal. You are advertising God. You are making God more popular than the kingdom of darkness. God bless you. Till I come your way again next Saturday, Boldness in Christ Jesus episode, 7 p.m. Spanish European time, 7 p.m. Nigeria time, 6 p.m. UK time, 8 p.m. I think 8 p.m. in Kenya too. Then 8 p.m. in South Africa, 1 p.m. New York. God bless you. I love you all. Shalom.